capacity in science is crucial for this to developing to being food secure. So unless we develop the capacity of Africans in-house to solving their own problems, I think we'll never be food secure.
Over the last 20 years, Segonet Kalemu's research and that of the team under her leadership have been of great help in overcoming the agricultural constraints in Latin America, Africa, Asia, and North America. Segonet Kalemu has recently become the first woman to head the ISIPE and is a TWAS prize winner.
I think TWAS is doing a fantastic job in linking all the developing country scientists in many different areas. I was really surprised, astonished to see the magnitude of people when I went to receive the award in China. So the magnitude, the variety of sciences, level, the quality of people, older generation, younger generation, it was phenomenal.
In the ISIPE Tropical Research Center on Lake Victoria, high-level researchers are looking for the most effective ways for fighting both insects that damage crops and parasitic plants that wipe them out.
When I came to Africa, I was amazed to see the problem of striga, which does not occur either in India or in the Philippines. And this looked that this is devastating, and the farmers will never be able to produce the food if striga is a problem. As you can see here, the crop looks very poor, and this being a parasitic weed, it has a root-to-root association with sorghum plant or maize plant, and it takes the nutrient out of the plant. And finally it dies, as you see here. The plant is dying because the nutrient is going out through the root to the parasitic weed. So this is a scenario which most of the farmers in Africa have.
Professor Khan has developed an innovative agricultural technology, starting out from a local, sustainable and holistic approach. The push-pull technology entails the use of perennials, the desmodium legume and elephant grass, as natural pesticides of two of the most major problems afflicting the farmers in these areas.
The plot I'm having, the first plot, I used to get only 4 kilograms of maize. But since I joined this technology of push-pull in that place, I'm getting more than 90 kilograms. But there before, it was terrible and miserable.
Jembe now.
I use a lot of strength digging, like but harvest, nothing, only 4 kilograms. Which could not satisfy the needs of my family and myself.
Today, as many as 60,000 families of small farmers in Western Kenya use the push-pull technology. But the direct benefits affect over 300,000 people in these parts. Professor Khan has recently been awarded a prize for his scientific research by TWAS. This is an important award which gives access to a network of scientists able to make a difference to the future of the planet. It is the young people living on university campuses like this who one day can become hydraulic, civil and electronic engineers or agricultural scientists, able to change the destiny of developing countries. If only they were given the opportunity to do high-level research and specialize where there are resources of knowledge and technology. Vitalis Wikesa's PhD would have been an unattainable goal without the support of TWAS and the Brazilian Council.
When I wrote a proposal to do my PhD, it was a continuation of my research work in ISIPE.
Vitalis Wikesa is engaged in research concerning biopesticides, natural and sustainable methods for fighting the pests of many edible plants. The 3 years he spent in Brazil gave him the chance to work closely with the best researchers in the field, using the most advanced technology.
It looked like it is not possible for me to reach this level. So you see now I am like the light in this village. Everybody sees me as an example.
The whole community finds it exceptional that one of them has made it, because to make it here, you really have to want it with all your might. Eighty percent of infectious diseases in developing countries are caused by contaminated water.
The river you are seeing here is called River Nairobi. It's a river which cuts in the midst of the town, and it serves almost more than a half of the Nairobi, you know, population.
Many of the inhabitants in this informal settlement drink the water from Nairobi River. After collecting it in makeshift containers, they leave it to stand for at least an hour, so they can drink the most transparent and apparently clean water left on the surface.
Because of using it in drinking, it causes pain in stomach. Because after every 2 weeks, abdominal pain because of this water.
Thanks to the support of TWAS, Professor Peter Singuto has recently been able to purchase a kit for the electrochemical analysis of water for his laboratory in the chemistry department of the University of Nairobi. These instruments are not available locally and, even more importantly, they are financially inaccessible.
Before I got the grant, I did not have even a single, working tool. So with the TWAS grant, I was able to buy the most important machine called a potentiostat, which can help me carry out all electrochemical studies in my laboratory. But before then, honestly, I did not have anything. So it's like TWAS has given me legs to start walking, a background to stand on.
I was so excited that I could not even sleep. Yeah, it was amazing, I tell you. I think this is the best thing that has ever happened to me in my life. To get a scholarship to go abroad and study for my PhD.